It's really hard to overestimate the impact of antibiotic resistance. The most recent data I'm aware of is that there are about 2 million antibiotic-resistant infections in the United States. These result in 23,000 deaths at a total cost of about $55 billion. And we're really only getting into the start of this. And on the horizon, we have very few answers for antibiotic resistance. There are very few antibiotics in development.
A report published by the CDC warns about the threat of antibiotic resistance. Resistant organisms have been aptly named nightmare bacteria for their ability to resist many of the antibiotics we have developed.
Part of the problem with antibiotics is that we didn't invent antibiotics. Fungi invented antibiotics hundreds of millions of years ago. And they have been using those antibiotics to fight bacteria. Well, the bacteria have had hundreds of millions of years to figure out what they have to do to respond to that fungal product that restricts their growth.
The overuse of antibiotics has been the largest contributing factor to the development of antibiotic resistance.
Our body has more bacteria than human cells, and those bacteria were put in by nature to protect us.
It still amazes me, but there are 10 bacteria in our body for every human cell. So we have 10 times more bacteria than human cells. We call this the microbiome. So if you take an antibiotic you don't need, you've just exposed every single one of your organisms to this antibiotic, leading to the potential for resistance in the future when you might actually need it to treat an infection.
By educating physicians and patients about the responsible use of antibiotics, healthcare providers hope to stall the inevitable spread of resistant bacteria.
There's still hope, but there's no doubt that treatment of infections, care of infections, has become much more complicated in the last 20 or 25 years because of the emergence of resistant organisms.